All right, let's take a look at what's going on down in the southwestern Gulf of Mexico. A high level potential or a high potential for this developing into either our next depression or storm, probably very soon, maybe even by tonight, as our satellite imagery has been over the last almost 3 days now showing a clear circulation. That circulation, though, so far has been very broad. In other words, a very large area of circulation. It would need to see that tighten up for the Hurricane Center to actually declare this a depression or a storm. Hurricane hunters are in the storm right now, or in this cluster of thunderstorms, and they are again finding that broad circulation, but not quite finding it very tightly developed. So what is going to be happening over the next couple of days? Well, not a whole lot as far as we are concerned. We are going to see it kind of being drawn northward over time and then kind of shifted off toward Texas and Mexico, and then maybe just sitting off the coast. Again, we've got a front on the way, which is really going to help to block this from ever trying to move toward the northern Gulf Coast. Computer models are in a little bit more agreement, at least with the Euro and GFS, both by Sunday at noon, kind of off the coast of South Texas. So something that folks in Texas will have to watch very closely. Problem also is most of our models kind of in the long range run don't really move it inland. They just kind of have it sit in the western Gulf. So this may be something we're dealing with as we continue on into next weekend. We're also watching this moisture from that system, not necessarily the system itself, but that moisture surging up over us, and that will increase our rain chances. While at the same time, we're also watching an upper trough. You can kind of see that motion across the northern plains. This is going to bring down some cooler air. Now, what is unlike our fall type cold fronts is that the upper trough isn't just plowing down to the Gulf Coast. It's actually going to get shifted more toward the Ohio River Valley and the East Coast. But what it is going to do is push that front on through. Now, we've got the cooler, drier air at the surface, but in the upper parts of the atmosphere, we're still going to have that flow coming out of the Gulf. So the moisture from that system will still be moving overhead. What that means is it feels very nice. It's cooler, it's less humid, while at the same time we stay under mostly cloudy skies and showers around, especially from the south shore down toward the coast. And I've got about a 40% chance of rain as we continue on through the weekend and next week. So very typical for an early fall front. You do get that taste of fall while at the same time still dealing with some of that tropical moisture. We've already seen some of the moisture moving over us. That's what kept our clouds around during the day today, but it was a very pretty day. No rain within those clouds, and it did help to keep our temperatures way down.